have been in this music industry for over 20 years.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yes.
It's very, very cool that you've had such a long lifespan in the music industry, because it's not that kind of industry anymore.
You think so?
Yeah, I mean, we get a lot of one-hit wonders. You hear one song.
I think it's because of all these competitions and these live, what is it, like the Idols and the Voice.
Yeah.
What I find from experiences is that if you want to sustain a career in the music industry, it kind of helps if you started off struggling.
Okay.
Not necessarily struggling, but when you've learned the ropes, when you had to actually do a lot of hard work to promote yourself, to get yourself out there, print your own little flyers and put it up and that kind of thing, because then you know when the times get tough how to do it, how to sustain the career. I think when you become famous through The Voice or The Idols, something like that, you haven't actually learned the ropes in the industry, and then that makes it harder for you to work at it and to sustain it. So yes, I started right at the very bottom playing background music. I remember performing at the Michelangelo Hotel or the Hilton, and almost every night someone would come up to me and say, "Excuse me, ma'am, do you think you can maybe just sing a little bit softer?" Or maybe one night somebody asked me if I could not sing at all and just play the piano, you know.
Oh,
so
my.
That's kind of the, and it makes you strong. I think these kind of things mold you and put you together and gives you character, and also gives you determination and strength to, when things don't go very well, then you know how to work through it, you know. So on this journey, yes, I've learned to grow very spiritually. Today I'm a motivational, inspirational speaker. I do coaching and life coaching. I combine music with healing and teaching. And so this is what I do, because on this journey to establish myself as a singer-songwriter in this country, I've actually learned to find myself, and I've learned to love and accept myself. So for me, that was the greatest achievement of all the accolades. And I have many awards, and I've got platinum selling albums, and I've performed with people like Andre Bocelli, and I've got a world published book. But out of all these accolades, I can honestly tell you the greatest one is learning to love and accept myself, and that is an ongoing journey.
So now onto the album.
Yes. Yeah.
What is the album called?
It's called My Beautiful Escape, and I reckon it's kind of a two-way thing, because I've noticed that so many of us actually find different ways of escaping reality or escaping life, because we just can't cope with the emotions and the feelings that it brings. And for me, it is a journey to enjoy this moment, enjoy this life, and to be present and to create a life that I don't want to escape from. And I think we escape it through watching TV or eating too much, or drugs. Now there's so many things, you know, even over-exercising, even the things that you think is good. Sometimes we use these things to escape our lives.
Yeah.
This was my journey back to discovering what I love, what I want, what I desire, that I'm worthy and deserving of these things, and how to create more of it into my life. You know, so for me, it is was a beautiful escape from the actual escape. You know,
so it's
coming back to yourself, coming back to the self. Yes.
That's amazing. And how long did it actually take you to create the album?
When I write albums, I usually give myself 2 years.
Okay.
But the last 3 years has been a tremendous shift in my life. My mom passed away about 5 years ago. It's actually now 13 July would be 5 years ago, and the greatest gift my mom gave me was kind of to make me feel again. For about 15 years before she passed, or 17 years before she passed, I kind of shut my heart, because I thought, this is so scary to feel, you know. When you feel that much, it's kind of overwhelming, and life is very scary. So I shut my heart and I started making decisions with my head. And you know, when we make decisions with our head, it's always based on fear, because your head will never give you, it will just give you the facts based on the fears, you know. So I've made a lot of decisions in my life based on fear, and they don't serve your highest good. So when my mom passed away, it was like this jolt, my heart just jolted back to life, and I could feel again. This album, I wrote from a place of true feeling, and I think I've lost that. This is my 8th album. My first 3 albums were very authentically from a place of feeling, and then I started writing, keeping people in mind, thinking, what would they like to hear? I kind of became a pleaser. I wanted to write what I think other people would want to hear. This album is again what I want to hear.
Okay.
It's healing for me. It's coming from a place of true authenticity and feeling from the bottom of my heart. Yes, so my favorite song on the album would be, I have three favorites. I think I always, if people check out track 7 on every one of my albums, it's my favorite number, so I always put my most favorite track on track 7. So this one is called Calling. It's not a commercial track in the sense that it would get radio play. It's kind of like a meditation because I did a lot of chanting and stuff in it.
Okay.
But it's very peaceful and it's so relaxing for me. So that's my favorite track. Then I love Soothe My Soul. And then a song that I guess could get radio play is Worth. And I guess it's because I discovered my worth and I realized that my worth cannot be defined by things outside of myself. It just is. So I love the song Worth. But this whole album is very exciting for me. I love driving in my car listening to it. And it's wonderful when you drive and you listen to your album and you go, I love this.
So what is that sound of Authentically You?
Oh, because I love so many different styles of music, I always call it like a quickie course, you know, a stir fry. I like to put everything into it. So on this album you'll find from, there's a little bit of everything on it, you know. I go from very Celtic to very, there's out of contemporary, there's even very pop kind of song, there's even kind of a house trance sound in some of the tracks. Yes, so even the club mix of one song that I think would be very nice. And a lot of ballads, I love ballads with beautiful messages. For me, it's always about the message. So every song is basically focusing on healing and sending a very positive, motivational, inspirational message out there. Listen, like I say, I'm just working on healing myself. And if some of this can mean something to someone else out there, wonderful. With this album, we've actually recorded a lot of real sounds.
Okay.
We were actually pouring sand into sound bowls. We actually sat in the recorded rain. There's also on the song Calling, if you hear birds, that's actually, I've done all the sounds with my voice, even the low frequencies and sounds like, sometimes it sounds like a bit of a didgeridoo, and then the bird sounds. So all of this is actually done with my voice, and even the wind that you hear, and there's all kinds of different sounds. We've created it out of real things from nature. So there's a lot of nature and real sounds that we actually create.
You are in great shape.
Oh, thank you.
How do you keep in shape? How does performing go for you?
Yes, performance is also a nice form of exercise, but mostly the vocal cords. I do yoga every night before I go to bed. Just a couple of stretching and deep breathing makes me feel very good and sleep well.
So will you be touring the album?
Yes, I've already done a nice big launch show in Pretoria. I was at Carnival City, so I'm planning a whole lot more. I'm going to PE and Cape Town. In October, I'm going to Russia because I'm going to perform at a Russian ball, which I'm very excited about. I'm also going to give a workshop on connective communication, so very exciting for me. And I'm going to also do some courses over there that I can bring back and share with people over here.
That's amazing. And what is the demand for your music like overseas?
Very much. You see, next year I'm going to Japan, so I do perform, because my music is online available, people can find this music on iTunes, and I have been touring the whole world, doing little performances everywhere, you know. So there is a definite great demand, because it's kind of like a world music, and being Afrikaans myself, but I just write in English, so I'm an English songwriter. I have some Afrikaans songs on some of my previous albums. But in general, I write in English because of the international audience.
So if we want to find you on social media, where can we find you?
Okay, so I have a website, www.nianell.com, Nianell, NIANELL.com. And there you'll find my Facebook, my Twitter, my YouTube page and everything. But if you're searching for me, just go to facebook.com/Nianell, NIANELL, or Nianell Music, Nianell. Slash music for my Twitter and my Instagram. I think there's Twitter, Instagram, and then the Facebook, and there's also a YouTube page where people can go and look at all my music videos. But if you don't know where to find me, just go to my website, www.nianell.com.
All right, excellent. And finally, is there anything that you want the readers to know specifically about your new album?
I believe that if you listen to this album, that you would find something very personal, very special, that can assist you in your life and that will help you heal something in your life. I believe that this album is very healing. I know this because I can feel it every time I listen to it. And I feel very thankful that I can share this with everybody.